It's a novel. It's a big novel. It's about a lot of things, but in the heart of it, the spine of the book is a mother-son story. It's about a mother, Faye, who unexpectedly leaves her family one day when her son, Samuel, is 11 years old, and he doesn't see her again for 20 years. He sees her finally committing a really absurd crime on television, a crime that sort of goes viral on the internet. And so he resolves to try to figure out not only what she's doing, but also where she's been the last 20 years and why she left the family when she did. And in so doing, he discovers this big epic story of hers that nobody ever knew about. I wanted to have two protests that were kind of bookends. There's the 1968 protest in Chicago, and then the 2004 protests in New York City, both of them protesting wars, the Vietnam War in one and the Iraq War in the other. And I wanted to be able to compare those two events, because I thought that there was a kind of echo of 1968 in contemporary America. I thought that our politics were as polarized and divisive as they were in 1968. And in 2004, a lot of people were wondering whether the protests would be as violent as they were in 1968. So there seemed to be some parallels about what was happening in America today and what happened in 1968. Samuel's problem is that his childhood was sort of cut off when his mother left, and that turned him into a kind of frightened person. And so his mother's influence is a big reason why he's sort of like that. So when we meet him at the beginning of the book, he has a job that he doesn't like, and he's spending most of his time playing video games. And I hope that the work of the book is to bring him out of his shell. As he learns more about his mother, he can kind of become a more full person. Faye has gone through the opposite journey. She was a very outgoing person who, because of various things in life, became much more sheltered. And hopefully the work of the book is bringing her out of her shell in her own way as these two people find each other again. In the book, it's a reference to ghost stories that Faye's father told her. Faye's father came to America from Norway, as did my family on my mother's side. And so it's stories from the old country is kind of what that refers to. But it's also has another meaning, that it's the old country in terms of you know, where the U.S. came from, you know, from 1968 till now, and whether indeed that's even old or not anymore. I like the title in French. I had never even thought about what the translated title might be. The Nix works in English, but it doesn't work in every other language, and so that's been a unique challenge for all of my foreign publishers. I don't think I would presume to try to make an argument about America. America is a much too big, diverse place for someone like me with my very limited point of view to make a grand statement about. But I was trying to get across what you know, life in 21st century America felt like to me, felt like on my nerve endings. And what it feels like is chaos, anger, people deeply misunderstanding each other. And so I wanted to write a novel that captured that feeling of just kind of the day to day, this is what it feels like to wake up in the morning kind of feeling. And if that captures a little bit of what life in the US feels like right now, then great. Yeah, I just finished two novels by American writers that I really loved. One is by Lauren Groff, who's at the festival. It's called Florida. I read it, one, because I'm a big Lauren Groff fan, but also because I live in Florida, and so does she. She really, not only does she capture Florida really well, but it's just a beautiful collection of short stories. And then the second book I just finished was a book by Sheila Hetty called Motherhood. And it's about its main character is struggling with whether she wants to be a mother or not. It's kind of a novel / kind of philosophical treatise at the same time. And it's brilliant, and I've never read anything like it. I'd really recommend those two books. They're great.